Hi there, Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and today I'm going to show you how to use the EOMONTH function in Excel 2016. First things first, let's just try it out in a blank cell. I'm going to type in equals EOMONTH, left parenthesis, quote. It's going to prompt us for our start date. I'm going to put in 01/01/2018, beginning of 2018. Make sure to put my end quote, and it's going to ask for months, and I'm going to put in 0. So what I want to get out of this is the end of January. What day does that fall on? Press enter and I get 43,131. That's not quite what I want. This is actually the serial number. So this is how many days have passed since January 1st, 1900. And Excel will often give you these almost random numbers from their date and time functions. Easy fix for it is go up to your number format tab. Click the down arrow and click short date. And now I can see that the end of the month for January 1st, 2018 is the 31st. The start date can be of a couple different formats. It can be of a standard date format that we just used. It can be in the serial number, so I can actually put in 43,113 and the argument will give me the end of the month for that particular date. And we can also put in now functions or today arguments or any other function that gives us a formatted date. Now one example here is I have a fictional super sub submarine service. Yeah, it's a work in progress. I got a bunch of rich people and I told them I would deliver a sub in a submarine to them and it would be super. Now they ordered on these days and I'm going to deliver it on the first day of the next month. So what I'm going to do is equals EO month, left parenthesis, it'll prompt me for my start date. And you might be thinking, this isn't quite the beginning of the month. Well, watch the magic happen. 0 months again, right parenthesis, plus 1. And that'll actually return to me the first of the month each and every time. Now to fill this for all my data, I can select the small green square here and click and drag all the way to the bottom. And oh, I see I have an error here. Oh, this client, it was a little bit special. They use a different date system. Everything's different there actually. I'm gonna put in just 4. And now I can see that everything works here. And all of these dates are 1. You can just look at it and see 1. I'm Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and we went over the EOMONTH function in Excel 2016. You can use it not just to find the end of the month, but also the beginning of the month. Say you need to send someone a bill or a letter or congratulations. You can use the EOMONTH function to organize that and process your data. If you have any questions, please comment and I'll be sure to answer them. Please leave a like below and subscribe if you like this content, and I wish you all a good day.